Hey everyone, I'm Lindsay and welcome back to UTBB Smokehouse Chats, our ongoing web series where we provide information and updates on the latest work to protect Bristol Bay. First, we hope everyone is safe and healthy amidst the COVID-19 health crisis, and our thoughts are with you all during these trying times. Unfortunately, and despite this global pandemic, the Trump administration is barreling forward with the Pebble Mine project, and we want to make sure you have up-to-date information and resources on how you can help fight back against this toxic mine. In this update, we're going to cover the latest information on Pebble's federal permit, which is slated for a final decision this summer. We'll also review the latest activity from the state of Alaska as it relates to the project. So first, the Army Corps, which is the federal agency that processes permits for the mega mines and massive development projects like Pebble, has been on a mission to fast-track Pebble's permit since their application was submitted in late 2017. The corresponding environmental review for the project, the Environmental Impact Statement, or EIS, has been universally condemned and identified as rushed and incomplete by the scientific community, by Congress, and by other federal agencies. Although the Army Corps has previously been directed by Congress to address the major problems with the EIS, they went ahead with releasing the near final version back in February anyway, and not surprisingly, it was still full of major data gaps, discrepancies, and missing scientific analyses. To sum it up, the Army Corps' environmental review of the Pebble project is a complete failure. Further, just a couple of weeks ago, the Army Corps announced that they are working with Pebble to finalize a northern transportation route for the mine, but they refused to announce any final details about that route until they issued a permit. This is significant for three main reasons. First, the northern transportation route has not been thoroughly vetted and scrutinized by the public and cooperating agencies, and warrants at minimum a supplemental EIS be conducted, which the Corps refuses to do. Second, the northern route crosses land areas that are not and will not become available for use associated with the Pebble Mine. The area that the northern route would cross include lands owned by Pedro Bay Corporation, Bristol Bay Native Corporation, and Igiaga Village Council, and they have made it clear that they will not grant Pebble permission to use their lands and resources. And third, this northern route plan is clear confirmation of what Pebble has been telling potential investors, that the Pebble partnership will operate beyond its current 20-year mine plan, as the northern route is the only feasible option to develop the entirety of the deposit, which leads to a 78-year mine. The Pebble partnership is continuing to promote a huge mining operation to investors while telling Alaskans and federal and state regulators that it only intends to mine for 20 years. And now we're stuck with an EIS that vastly underestimates the potential impacts of this proposed project on the world's most valuable and important wild sockeye salmon fishery. So what happens next and what can we do about it? The Corps has stated that they will release the final EIS this summer, most likely in July, and then they'll issue a Record of Decision, commonly known as a ROD or a permit decision, this fall. This will result in the fastest permit decision in U.S. history for a project of this size. It is clear that the Corps is operating on a political timeline to try and issue a permit for the Pebble project before Election Day in November. Despite the EPA's politically motivated withdrawal of the proposed Clean Water Act protections for Bristol Bay last year, the scientific and public records still support protections for our region from Pebble, and the EPA does still have the authority to veto Pebble's permit. In fact, last fall, the EPA was encouraged by Congress to put protections in place if the environmental review doesn't adequately assess the mine's impacts on Bristol Bay. It is clear that the Army Corps' environmental review has failed, and we must push our leaders to hold the EPA accountable and to uphold their responsibility to veto Pebble. Please use your voice to send a letter to the EPA and our elected leaders today. A link to a letter is in the comments below. And finally, a short update in the state arena. As you know, Alaska's governor has been supporting the Pebble project in various and concerning ways since he took office. Most recently, he nominated Pebble's Director of Regional Affairs, Abe Williams, to replace Fritz Johnson of Dillingham on the State Board of Fisheries, which governs management of sport, commercial, and subsistence fishing across Alaska. The Board of Fish appointees usually go through public confirmation hearings in the Alaska legislature. Due to the coronavirus, Abe may be allowed to take that seat in July without ever having a public hearing or a vote. It's clear that the governor is taking advantage of the current situation to keep boosting the Pebble project at the expense of local residents and Alaskans, and anyone who will depend on the Bristol Bay fishery. Abe Williams is a longtime Pebble advocate, and as a current Pebble employee, cannot be an objective representative for Alaska fishery issues. We need the legislature to step in and stop him from being confirmed, so please reach out to your legislators today. Finally, stay tuned throughout the summer for more information and updates. If you want more resources or clarification on the things we've covered today, remember that you can always get the latest news and information on our Facebook page and on our website at utbb.org. Thank you for your continued dedication to protecting Bristol Bay, and have a safe and healthy summer.